Hello students, this is your English lesson. In this lesson we are going to read a story, The Poet and the Jester, unit number 7 from Oxford Reading Circle 5. Let's get started. Do you remember reading about Vadim, the boy from Yantaya? Well, he grew up and he did become a famous poet. His name spread far and wide, and his friends often told him to go to the court of the King Valdemar and to seek a job there. The king would be able to pay him well and look after him, because that is exactly what this king used to do. In his court there were many wise and skillful people, and they were all looked after by the king. Vadim, or Vadim of Yantaya, as he was now known, thought that this was a good idea. However, he did not know how he could get into the court of the king. Then one day, a man called Mikhailovic, who was very close to the king, came to a place near Yantaya. Vadim's friends told him about this man. Go and see him, they urged. He will surely be of some help. Vadim hurried to the nearby village and found Mikhailovic. He begged for an audience with this powerful man, and when Mikhailovic heard it was the famous poet, he readily agreed to see Vadim of Yantaya. Vadim came before Mikhailovic and was careful to be polite. He did not want to upset the man with his jokes or sharp comments. Instead, he read out some of his poems. Mikhailovic was most impressed. What a fine way you have with words, young man, he said. You have written some fine poems. The king will like them immensely. Immensely? Extremely. So you must come along and read them to him. Vadim was excited by this opportunity, and he thanked Mikhailovic most gratefully. Yes, indeed, continued Mikhailovic, and then added rather grandly and much to Vadim's disappointment, I shall try and remember to send for you one of these days. Vadim returned to Yantaya and hoped that Mikhailovic would remember to call him to the court of the king one day. But the days rolled on and the weeks. Still, there was no news from Mikhailovic. Vadim became impatient with the waiting. One fine day, he packed up his poems and all his personal belongings and, along with his wife, set off for Nekord, the capital of the kingdom. The very next day, after he arrived in Nekord, Vadim went to the Mikhailovic's grand house. The house was surrounded by gardens and a huge wall. There were guards at the gate, but the walls and the guards did not stop Vadim. He marched straight past the guards into the grounds of Mikhailovic's house. When the guards tried to stop him, he brushed them aside. How dare you lay your hands on me? He complained bitterly. Do you know who I am? An old friend. The guards were taken aback and allowed Vadim to enter the house. They did not think to ask, whose old friend are you? Once inside the house, Vadim found his way to where Mikhailovic was sitting. The great man was relaxing after having eaten a vast breakfast, and he was most surprised and annoyed to see this uninvited visitor in his private chambers. Who are you? What on earth are you doing here? He spluttered. Spluttered? Say something rapidly. I am Vadim, Vadim of Yantaya. You remember? You told me to come and... But the great man did not let Vadim finish his explanation. Guards, guards, yelled Mikhailovic, get this man out of here. And the guards, who had followed Vadim into the house but had kept their distance, pounced on him and pinned him to the floor. Vadim of Yantaya, indeed, this is Nekord. Not Yantaya, said Mikhailovic, as the guards bundled poor Vadim out onto the street. Vadim sat in the street feeling very sore. He made up his mind to get even with the king's friends. The following day, after Vadim had time to think and to nurse his hurt limbs and his pride, he made his way to the king's court. Many common citizens were going to be at the court that day, as the king had arranged for a famous magician from the north to entertain his people. Vadam slipped unnoticed into the court with all the others. The king and all the ministers and other important guests sat close to the stage. The magician, dressed in a long flowing robe and wearing a turban decorated with stars and a bright yellow moon, suddenly appeared on the stage in a cloud of blue smoke. The king clapped and applauded praise by clapping, as did the minister and guest. The common folk standing apart shouted and whistled and cheered. Vadam edged closer to the stage and to the king. He was also getting closer to Makhwalich, who was sitting right next to the king. The magician was superb. He performed trick after trick that amazed and greatly entertained the audience. After the last and most difficult trick in the program, one in which the magician appeared to remove his head and hold it aloft in his outstretched hands, aloft overhead, the crowd went wild with delight. The applause in the hall rattled the rooftop like thunder. Then, as silence slowly returned, the magician turned to the king and announced, "Your Majesty, I hope you have enjoyed my performance. With your permission, I would like to challenge anyone in your court to equal the feats I have performed today." "You have my permission," said the king, and he turned to this side and that to see whether anybody would take up the challenge. No hands were raised and no voices were heard. The king was little embarrassed and ashamed that there was not a single magician in the court that day, or one brave enough to take up the challenge. Makhwalich and the other ministers did not know quite where to look. There was a buzz of excitement in the hall as Vadim pushed his way to the front, saying, make way, let me through." Vadim stepped onto the stage and bowed to the king. "Your Majesty," he said, "with your permission, I would like to take up the challenge of this magician. I have better tricks up my sleeve than he could ever dream of." The king was both amused and encouraged by Vadim's word. After all, nobody else had stepped forward, so this brave soul must have some good trick to perform. Otherwise, the king and his kingdom would be laughed at forevermore. "Please continue, young man," said the king. "I first need something for the trick, Your Majesty, so with your permission, I did like to ask one of your servants to fetch something for me." "Go ahead, but be quick about it." "Well, we haven't got all day," replied the king. Vadim went up to one of the attendants and whispered in his ear. The man trotted off at great speed and Vadim returned to the stage. While the crowd watched and waited, Vadim paced up and down the stage. "Who are you and where are you from?" asked the king. "I am Vadim of Entaya, from a small village called Entaya," replied Vadim. "But nobody here, not even Makhwalich, your trusted friend and advisor, knows or cares where that is." Makhwalich turned crimson, became flushed with embarrassment as all eyes in the hall turned towards him. His further blushes were saved by the arrival of the attendant carrying a small packet. The attendant handed the packet to Vadim and left the stage. Vadim was not going to let Makhwalich get off so lightly. "I am not really a magician, Your Majesty, but a humble poet. I am a poor man without the wealth and influence of great people such as your advisor, Makhwalich." The king smiled and nodded. "Well, Vadim of Entaya, your name is known here today. And if you manage to perform a trick that our friend from the north cannot equal, then you shall be rewarded with a bag of gold. But I must warn you that if you fail, you will get 100 lashes for wasting our time." "Certainly, Your Majesty," said Vadim and bowed to the king. Vadim now turned to address the magician. "Sir," he said, "I shall perform a trick with my eyes closed. All you have to do is to perform the same trick with your eyes open." The magician from the north held his belly and laughed loudly. "With my eyes open," he said, "I too shall do any trick that you can do with my eyes closed." "No, I shall do it with my eyes closed," You must agree to do it with your eyes open, replied Vadim. All right, all right, replied the magician. I shall do it with my eyes open. With pleasure, Vadim opened the packet that the attendant had brought him. He took a handful of the powder that was in it and then closed his eyes. He sprinkled the powder all over his face and eyes. A tissue. Vadim sneezed loudly. Then he dusted the powder from his face with his towel and opened his eyes. The audience looked on in amazement. Now it's your turn, said Vadim to the magician. But remember, do it with your eyes open. But what is this powder? Asked the bewildered magician. It's only a little chili powder, said Vadim, smiling broadly. Cheers and applause broke out all over the hall. The audience fell to the floor with laughter. The king too laughed for a long time, and even Mikhailich permitted himself a little smile. Excellent, said the king, wiping away his tears. You deserve your reward, and from today you shall be part of my court. I have not laughed so much in ages. You really are a funny fellow. Vadim of Yantaya was delighted. He spent many happy years at the court, and his fame grew from day to day. Now come to the exercises. Questions 1. What did Vadim want from Mikhailich? Answer. Mikhailich was a close associate of the king, and Vadim wanted his help to get to the king's court. 2. How did Mikhailich get impressed with Vadim? Answer. Mikhailich was very impressed with Vadim's use of words and fine poems. 3. Why do you think Vadim did not get a good welcome at Mikhailich's house? Answer. Vadim did not get a good welcome at Mikhailich's house, as Mikhailich did not recognize Vadim and was very annoyed at being disturbed. He ordered his guards to throw a man out on the street. 4. Why did Vadim decide to approach the king directly? Answer. Vadim decided to visit the king to get even with the king's friend Mikhailich. 5. Why do you think Mikhailich only permitted himself a little smile? Answer. Mikhailich had earlier promised to call Vadim to read his poems to the king, but he had not kept his words. Therefore, when Vadim tricked the magician, Mikhailich could only permit himself a little smile. B. Reference to context. Explain the reference to context in which the following phrases were spoken. A. Made up his mind, made a decision. B. Taken aback, shocked or stunned. C. Get even with, to take revenge, to repay in kind. D. Standing apart, separate. E. Tricks up his sleeve, have many other plans ready. F. Get off lightly. B. Shrugged without embarrassment. G. His blushes were saved from being embarrassed, humiliated. C. Words and meanings. Find the meanings of the following words and phrases using a dictionary. A. Immensely, to a great extent, extremely. B. Taken aback, shocked or surprised. C. Feeling very sore, feeling hurt. D. Crimson with embarrassment, turn red with embarrassment, extremely embarrassed. E. Trotted off, proceed away briskly. 2. Use these expressions in sentences of your own. 1. Far and wide. He searched far and wide for a suitable bride for his son. 2. High and low. My mother looked high and low but could not find the ring she had lost. 3. Here and there. I dropped the marbles and they scattered here and there. 4. Now and then. I visit my grandmother now and then. 5. Over and over. Vadim repeated the magic words over and over. Thanks for listening. For new videos, don't forget to subscribe my channel. And if you like my videos, please share and like.